Queen-fans så kommer här en liten kort historik över en av rockens största kvinnliga förebilder.
Det var det här som mötte en exploderande indie-scen i början av 90-talet. Dry, en av de mest övertygande debuter från den här perioden. Det lät inte som ett verk från en debutant. Hon var självklar från första stund. En utvecklad låtskrivare och karismatisk scenperson med lysande framtidsutsikter. Det stora publika genombrottet kom 1995 med skivan To Bring You My Love. Där hade hon lämnat sina båda bandkompisar från de bägge första skivorna för att ges ut helt på egen hand. De stökiga gitarrerna lades åt sidan, men melodierna och texterna var lika viktiga som förut. Sex, religion, kärlek, ofta med svart humor, var och är hennes favoritämnen. Rika ämnen att jobba med för vilken låtskrivare som helst kan man tycka. Men få gör det så naturligt och levererar det så övertygande som PJ Harvey.
As I get older, I feel more and more that I'm absolutely doing what I'm supposed to be doing on this earth, and I feel completely dedicated to making music and writing songs, and I can't ever imagine a time when I'm not doing that. When Dry came out 12 years ago, I was very unprepared for the reaction that happened. I was a very quiet, naive country girl, and suddenly, you know, there was this enormous amount of interest, and the record did very well and gained a lot of attention very quickly. And I not sure that I was very prepared for that. It did take me by surprise as well, because I really didn't expect the record to be at all popular. I thought that I couldn't imagine anyone wanting to listen to it other than myself. So it really did surprise me. I was always someone at school that didn't fit in, and I've felt that throughout my life. And I think that maybe a lot of people that are artists in some medium or other can feel that. And it's interesting to me. I wonder if it is because to be able to... I think to do what artists do, you are a very, very sensitive person, because you absorb everything around you all the time. It's a bit like being a sponge. You kind of mop up lots of information all the time, and you're very hypersensitive. And that is kind of the blessing that we have of being able to then articulate all these things that we mop up, and somehow be able to converse that with other people in whatever way. One question that people sometimes ask is music a cathartic experience? Is it like relieving yourself of it? No, it's not. It's a form of expression, but it's not therapy. You know, it doesn't solve problems. And I think the other big mistake people often make is that everything I've ever written isn't autobiographical details of my life. It's not. You know, I'm an artist that observes what's going on around me, observes life, other people's lives, observes films, paintings that move me and want to express that feeling of being moved. And, you know, my albums are not a document of my life. They are a document of the way I see things, not just the things inside of me, but the things I see around me.
Just like